Hey guys, it is Patrick. Welcome or welcome back to my YouTube channel. So if you are new here, hi, I'm Patrick. And I make really, really awesome coffee drinks, different recipes that you can make at home that taste amazing. I really do think my recipes are some of the best here on YouTube, and I think you will be obsessed with them. And if you are back, welcome. It's so good to see you again. Hi, how are ya? Anyways, so obviously I post here on YouTube, but you can also follow me on Instagram. I am at pmeyer01. I took a little bit of an Instagram hiatus, but I'm gonna start posting soon, so like my pics, please. And I'm always posting on my story over there, so if you wanna interact with me, have that little bit of a deeper connection, be sure to follow me on Instagram. So, normally I'm over here making Starbucks drinks, but I'm dabbling with the enemy. With the enemy, girl. I am messing with the competition. So, I never thought this day would come, but I am going to be recreating a Dunkin' coffee recipe. What? So I know Starbucks has a cult following. If you were watching my videos, you are probably part of the Starbucks cult. I'm also a part of this cult. And over here, we have the Dunkin' cult. Now, oh my gosh, these Dunkin' girlies swear Dunkin' coffee is so much better. It's so much cheaper. It's just, it hits different than Starbucks. I tend to just gravitate towards Starbucks because she's kind of just giving me that bougie, I feel like elevated when I'm drinking Starbucks. Dunkin', I kind of feel like I'm down here. Starbucks, I feel like I'm up here. Dunkin' has always kind of just been like a donut place to me. Like, I know they're trying to rebrand themselves as being like more inclusive to the coffee community, but I've always just kind of known them for their donuts.
But,
So during the holiday season, they made this really, really good sugar plum macchiato. I found out about it like 2 weeks after it released. If I found out earlier, I totally would have done like a copycat recipe for you guys. If they release it next year, I will definitely do that. But I tried it and I was like, what? Starbucks doesn't really have anything like this. Like, I feel like Dunkin's like creative team is like almost like catching up or even above Starbucks. Like, so Starbucks obviously does provide us with a few seasonal drinks, a little special release here and there, but Dunkin', she's kind of pulling through. So since Valentine's Day is approaching, they released two new specialty drinks. So they released the Mocha Macchiato, which I think I'm gonna try in my next video. And they released what I'm making here today, the Pink Velvet Macchiato. This is amazing to me. Red Velvet Cake is my favorite cake flavor in the world. It is so good. Oh my gosh. The buttermilk, the cream cheese frosting, the little bit of cocoa in there. It is so good. Plus, it's better because this is pink velvet. So red velvet is obviously the classic, but pink velvet is almost like the trendy sister of red velvet. So we obviously have that really rich red velvet, pink velvet flavor on top of espresso. Starbucks has not released anything that creative in a while, in my opinion, and it's really made me look at Dunkin' differently. How I used to think about Dunkin' has completely shifted now. It's not like I'm leaving the Starbucks cult, but I'm also joining the Dunkin' cult. I feel like I'm a double cult member. So I went ahead and tried it, fell in love with it, and I knew I had to recreate this for you guys. So I did my research. I found out how I can get this pink velvet flavor into a drink using ingredients that are easy to find for you guys. And I think I did it. I don't think you guys are ready for this, so strap yourself in and let's get on with this recipe. So this recipe has three ingredients in total. You guys, at this point, you know I'm infamous for my easy recipes that taste just like the original. So the first thing we're gonna have to make is the pink velvet milk portion that goes on the bottom of the drink. So how are we gonna get this pink velvet cake, cream cheese frosting-y flavor into the milk? I'ma tell you. This is the secret ingredient to this drink. This is red velvet cake syrup. So if you don't know, there are a ton of flavored syrups that are specifically meant to go in like lattes, frappuccinos, iced coffee, stuff like that. They make like a billion different flavors, and I was able to find one that is red velvet cake flavored. I'm obsessed. This, when I found this, I was like, oh. I need this in my life. So this is from the brand Da Vinci Gourmet. So all you guys are gonna have to do is hop on Amazon. I will leave a link for this in the description box down below. Hop on Amazon, add this to your cart, and let it come to your house. You don't have to leave the house, no. I'm obsessed. This made my job so easy, and when I tell you, it tastes like red velvet. It tastes like red velvet. Now, I will admit, this is probably not the most natural recipe on my channel. Yeah. This is a little, I would say, I don't want to say artificial, but artificial. It is, but I don't care, period. This is what I'm using. You get an entire bottle, and this whole bottle contains 25 servings. So that means I'm getting 25 pink velvet macchiatos at home from this. Yes. So I'm going to be making a large, oh my God. I miss saying venti. Oh my God. Dunkin' is so boring. They have like small, medium, large. Starbucks is just more bougie. They're giving me grande. They're giving me venti. They're giving me trenta. But I do have Da Vinci. But I'm gonna go ahead and make a large. So if you want a smaller drink or like a medium sized drink, then just kind of tweak and adjust this recipe. I don't know how the condensed red velvet flavor into a syrup. I probably don't want to know, but the flavor is spot on. So I'm gonna go ahead and add 3 tablespoons of this to my measuring cup, and that equates to like 1.5 ounces. If you want a little bit less flavor, a little bit more flavor, just kind of adjust this. Okay, so I'm gonna pour this into a 2-cup measuring cup. Okay, so now it is time to add my milk. I'm going to add like 1.25 cups of milk to this. Okay, so the milk and the syrup are stirred together. Let's set this aside while we make our espresso. Okay, so now it is time to go ahead and make my espresso. My favorite method to making espresso is using instant espresso powder. It is so cheap, easy, and it does not require a espresso machine. Now you can make this a lot of different ways. Obviously, if you have an espresso machine, go ahead and use it. If you don't have this, but you have like really, really strong coffee, that works perfectly as well. Okay, so I have 4.5 ounces of water in my 1-cup little measuring cup here, and I'm gonna put this in the microwave until it is boiling. Okay, and just like that, our water is boiling. Literally took under a minute in the microwave. This is why I love this method so much. It takes no time at all. And it is super easy for those of you who are just getting into making like coffee drinks at home. No fancy equipment is required, and you don't have to use like a special technique. It's really just as easy as stirring this powder into the water, and you're good to go. So now I can go ahead and add in my 1.5 teaspoons of espresso powder. Okay, so our powder is in here, and now I can just stir it until everything is combined and all of the little granules are dissolved. And now we are ready to assemble our drink. Oh my God. Okay, so I'm just going to assemble this whole drink in this little clear tumbler here. I'm so sad I can't use my Starbucks tumbler, but I feel like that would be a little bit of a conundrum because this isn't a Starbucks coffee cup. And I don't really have a Dunkin' tumbler yet, so I'm just gonna use this basic one. Let's build our drink. And I don't think I mentioned this yet, but this is obviously an iced drink. I'm sure you could make this hot, but I like all of my drinks iced. So let's add, ice. Okay, so we added my ice maybe like 2/3 of the way full. This is the amount of ice that I like in my drinks, but obviously since you're making it at home, you're the boss of your drink, you can add as much or as little as you want to. We love reclaiming that power. And for iced macchiatos, it is milk on the bottom and espresso on top, so now we can go ahead and pour in our pink velvet milk. Oh my gosh. And the espresso really is not gonna take up that much room, so you're gonna fill most of the cup with the milk. And now we can pour our espresso over the milk. It's gonna create that really good two-toned effect that iced macchiatos have. Oh my gosh, you guys, our drink is finally done. Let me give this a stir and let's give it a try. I don't know how they do it. This red velvet flavor isn't like, it kinda tastes like red velvet. No, no, it tastes like red velvet. Like what? As a red velvet enthusiast, I endorse this flavor. Wow. You get the red velvet flavor, but you also get that espresso too. It's almost like having a red velvet cake and a coffee, but in one. Like, what? Thank you guys so much for watching this video. If you loved it, be sure to give me a thumbs up, leave a comment down below, follow me on Instagram, subscribe to my channel, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye.